Biggest lesson you learned about your team in the off season would have been what?
Well, I think they're willing to work. We've got a long way to go. We had to change the culture, like every head coach says, but we needed to do that. I think I think their willingness to pay the price, willingness to listen, and willingness to put in the time to be good, and that's half the battle, you know. And again, now we've got a ways to go there yet, but I feel like we're getting there.
6-4, first round of the playoffs. So then expectations this year would be what?
Region championship. We're proud of 6-4. We're not satisfied with 6-4. We've got a tough schedule. We've got some outstanding teams. We've got to play. Anybody can beat you. You know, on a given day, anybody can beat you. So I think we're better, John. I really do. I think we're better. And we want to win our region. And then we want to get into the playoffs and take them one week at a time and see what happens from there.
So look at region for me, and who do you see?
Well, it's a good region. It's a tough region. Of course, the returning champion, Pierce, it'll be interesting to see what happens there with a new coach. And they've got good players. They've got good athletes. I think they'll certainly be a team to, reckon with. Liberty, we were fortunate last year. We played a great game, beat Liberty 34-0, but they got good teams, good players, good coaching. We go to Liberty. That'll be a tough outing. They advanced in the playoffs last year. So, I think there'll be two teams that jump up front that, you think, well, we obviously got to contend with them. Then I think everybody, I think Long will be better. I think Brantley obviously is going to be better. And I feel like, obviously that we'll be better. Tattnall, works hard. We play them at the end of the year. So, I think that it's an open region. I think anybody can win it. Anybody can beat you. But, I would think the front runners, obviously, the team goes 13-0 from last year. Pierce would certainly be the front runner.
And I know that coaching itself has changed even in the last 5 years. What has been the biggest challenge for you since the sport has changed?
Well, I think it's and I don't mean to get too philosophical here.
Go for it.
The biggest thing, and our guys are learning this now, and I'm proud of them, there's a big difference between pain and injury. We'll never ask an athlete to play with an injury. But we may ask him to practice and play with a little bit of pain, a little discomfort. Nowadays, I think we're in a hysteria about this concussion issue. I may have said this last year. There's a time when a player just gets dinged. He gets the heck knocked out of him. I saw a T-shirt one time that said, if you're not dizzy, if you're not sweating profusely, if you're not a little confused, you're not practicing hard enough. Well, that dadgum thing's out the window now. These guys don't, but some of our players have learned, all I got to do is go to the trainer and say, I got a little oi-oi, and hey, you're out for a week or 2 weeks or whatever. And that's the biggest thing. I think back in the day, John and I are great friends, by the way. He's covered our teams in the past. But our Washington County boys, those guys, gosh, I loved them so much. They'd show up at 5 o'clock and practice naked, if you ask them to. They'd do whatever you want them to do. Let's play. Let's go play, coach. I miss that. And these guys are getting there. They're getting there. They're about to get to that point where they're willing to do whatever it takes to be good.
Does that include going and practicing naked at 5 a.m.?
They'll do it.
Okay.
They're getting there.
I just wanted to see the nods of the
heads. They're getting there, yeah.
All right, so then you're king for a day. You're king of football for a day. There's one thing you could change. What would it be?
Wow, that's a tough question. I think I'd make every boy in school play. Go out and play. I think it does everybody good to play football. The camaraderie, the toughness, the price you've got to pay. I love basketball, I love baseball, I love track. Heck, I'm an athletic director, I love all sports. But there's something about a combative sport where there's 11 people involved. It requires a great deal of strategy, a great deal of organization. I just think it teaches you so much about life. So I could be king for a day. I'd make every boy in every school in America come out and play football and practice one day.